Good afternoon and welcome to OC Eagle Sports Network and OC Eagle Radio. We are just a few minutes away from the opening tip-off between the OC Lady Eagles and the University of Arkansas Fort Smith Lions. These two teams are fighting for third place in the Heartland Conference today. Lady Eagles are coming off of a big win on Thursday night against Rogers State. And today, starting for the Lady Eagles, you have your whole, all five seniors are going to be starting today. And starting off for the Lady Eagles, number 10, a senior, Emma Gady. Number 21, another senior, McKenzie Stanford. Number 33, Sarah Parker. Number 32, Kylie Hicks. And number 31, Hannah Holosek. And starting for the Lions of University of Arkansas, Fort Smith, we have number 3, Michaela Haynes, a 5'5 freshman from Guthrie, Oklahoma. Number 4, Sydney Franklin, a 5'7 senior from West Fork, Arkansas. Number 13, Olivia Hansen, a 5'11 junior from Fort Smith, Arkansas. Number 24, Maya Perry, a 5'10 senior from Huntsville, Texas. And number 40, Tyla Taylor, a 6'1 junior from Marlin, Texas. And like we said earlier, Oklahoma Christian coming off of, you kind of want to say an easy win against Rogers State on Thursday, but that was also a big win for Coach Finley, as that was her 600th win of her career, as well as her 1,000th game to coach.
Well, and the Lady Eagles right now are on a 3-game winning streak. They've defeated Texas A&M International. They've defeated St. Mary's. They've defeated Rogers State. Now it's time to take on. They've got a couple of games left against Arkansas Fort Smith and against Lubbock Christian that could decide if they are the fifth seed or the third seed. They could drop down to 5 or stay there, or they can move up to number 3. It's all going to depend on the next couple of games.
And the Lions get the tip-off. Number 4, Sydney Franklin with the ball. Passes inside. It's almost stolen away by Emma Gady. And a travel is called. So that will be the Lady Eagles basketball. Kylie Hicks takes the ball up the court for the Lady Eagles. The last time these two teams played was at Fort Smith. And Sarah Parker with the easy layup. Lady Eagles lead 2-0. But the last time these two teams played each other, OC lost by 5. So it was a really close game. That was when the Lady Eagles were kind of struggling there for a couple of weeks and not playing the best basketball. So hopefully we're going to see a change in that today. And the Lions get an easy layup of their own. Sarah Parker up top, passes inside to Stanford, and a foul is called. And that foul is going to be called against Taylor. That a reaching foul called on Taylor. Emma Gady with the ball, passes inside to Stanford. Stanford, the jumper, and the Lady Eagles lead 4-2 with 8 minutes, 52 seconds remaining in the first.
Well, and you've already got Sarah Parker who scored, McKenzie Stanford as well. You've got two of your leaders on the scoring end of the game, but also two of your big seniors scoring early and trying to take the game away from Arkansas Fort Smith early.
Sydney Franklin misses the 3, and Taylor goes up for the putback, and she's called for a charge, and that's already her second foul. So the Lions already in a little bit of foul trouble for Taylor, at least. And Coach Finley going with all of her seniors because it's senior day, but also this was the same group that started in Thursday night's game, so they have a good enough amount of experience with these specific 5 players playing together. Haynes with the ball up top. Passes over to Perry. And back up top to Haynes. Haynes drives all the way inside. The shot is blocked, and Sarah Parker takes the ball up the court. Trying to go behind her back is stolen away by Perry. Perry goes all the way down, layup, and we have a tied ball game at 4 with 7:45 remaining in the first.
And just an unfortunate turnover to start off the game, kind of have a little bit of a mistake and then get an easy layup. You don't want to be giving that up throughout the game. But Oklahoma Christian doing a little bit better the other night on turnovers, and they played a little bit better, not having so many turnovers, not turning the ball over quite as much.
And McKenzie Stanford with a layup. And Lady Eagles take back the lead, 6-4. Three-pointer put up, no good. And it's rebounded by Dickerson. And she makes the putback, and she's fouled. A three-point opportunity here. And the Lions taking a free throw now. And the free throw is good by Perry. Kylie Hicks taking the ball up the court. And OC down by 1, 7-6. Stanford on the left wing, up top to Gady. And it's knocked out of bounds by Dickerson. So that will stay with the Lady Eagles. Throwing the ball in from the right side of the court all the way over to Stanford on the left wing. Up top to Hicks. And down in the short corner to Holosek, and a foul is called. That foul called against number 22, Tamara Gulley. That is her first and the team's third. Stanford on the left wing. Hands it off to Holosek, over to Parker. And it's stolen away by Franklin. Franklin on the right wing, passes up top to Haynes. And Haynes to Perry. Perry on the left wing. And stolen away by McKenzie Stanford. Stanford pulls the ball out at the right wing. Emma Gady with the ball now. Passes down low to Stanford. Stanford dribbles, spins, puts up a shot, and misses, and it's rebounded by Franklin. Haynes up top. Perry on the left wing, back to Haynes. And now with Franklin on the right wing. 8 seconds left on the shot clock, and Haynes puts up a jumper from the elbow, and it's no good, rebounded by Parker. And another foul called against the Lady Lions. That foul called against Michaela Haynes. That is her first foul and the team's fourth. Lady Eagles throwing the ball in from the right side of the court. Holosek on the left wing. Now Stanford on the left wing. Top of the key, Sarah Parker. Pass inside to Holosek. She goes in for a layup, misses, and it's rebounded by the Lions. Haynes at the top of the key. Passes down to Franklin on the right corner. Back up top to Haynes. Puts up the three-pointer, and that's good. The Lady Lions lead 10-6 now. Kylie Hicks going quickly up the court. And inside to Parker. Parker puts up a shot, and she's fouled. She'll go to the line for two. That foul is called against number 24, Perry. And that is her first foul and the Lions' fifth, but We have a timeout called, so we'll take that with them. Be right back after this break on Eagle Sports Network.
Hands can do incredible things. Now they can even help save a life with hands-only CPR. If you see an adult suddenly collapse, just call 911, then push hard and fast in the center of the chest until help arrives. Learn more at handsonlycpr.org.
And welcome back to Eagle Sports Network. Number 5, Addie Clift, and 34, Audrey Hayes, checking into the game for the Lady Eagles. And Sarah Parker shooting free throws, misses the first one.
And Parker, one of the best free throw shooters for Oklahoma Christian on the season. She actually leads the team in free throw shooting percentage.
And she gets the second one to go in. Lady Eagles down by 3, 10-7. Franklin takes a three-pointer from the corner, misses, and Perry gets the rebound. The putback is no good. Passed back up top and over with Franklin now. Back to Perry. Perry misses the three, and it's rebounded by Stanford. Stanford pulls up at the three-point line, misses the shot, and it's rebounded by Haynes.
And Oklahoma Christian really getting out-rebounded today. Arkansas Fort Smith already has 8 rebounds compared to only 2 for Oklahoma Christian.
And Addie Cliff down to Stanford. Stanford with the layup. And that's one of those plays that you would like to see start happening more often in this game.
Well, and right now it's a back-and-forth game. Both of these teams playing pretty well. So it's been a pretty evenly matched game. Nobody really taking the lead at this point. But Oklahoma Christian going to have to play a little bit better to try and take that lead.
Addie Cliff with the three-pointer. And it's good to see her already with a three-pointer in this game. She had about either 3 or 4 in Thursday night's win. Lady Eagles tied the game up at 12 now. Perry takes a jumper, no good, rebounded by Gady.
Well, and the big thing about on Thursday night, Addie didn't have to shoot a whole lot because Oklahoma Christian was making shots from everywhere and having a pretty good all-around game from the get-go.
And Emma Gady with an easy layup, and Fort Smith calls a timeout, just a 30-second timeout, so we can keep it right here. But it did look like the beginning of this game, the Lady Eagles kind of struggling. It maybe just not playing their fullest at that moment. But with the last three possessions OC has had, they've scored. So you hope to see that more.
Well, and the Lady Eagles are shooting 60% for the game tonight. Arkansas Fort Smith shooting only 36%. But the difference right now is Arkansas Fort Smith has 5 more rebounds. They're having a lot more extra opportunities. They actually have 5 offensive rebounds. Oklahoma Christian with 0 on the day. So OC's going to have to do a little bit better about blocking out, getting those defensive rebounds, and not allowing them to have second possessions.
And Arkansas Fort Smith throwing the ball in by the Eagles basket. Castillo with the ball up top. Passes out to Franklin. And inside to Dickerson. Shot put up, missed, and a foul on the rebound. So that will send McKenzie Stanford to the free throw line.
And Arkansas Fort Smith having a lot of turnovers, or excuse me, a lot of fouls called early in this game. We've already seen one of their players get two personal fouls in Taylor, and she's already exited out of the game, but you've also got Perry now picking up her second.
And, you know, most likely, as Perry checks out of the game, most likely we're not going to see those two players until the second half. And it's good for the Lady Eagles, really bad for the Lions. The missed free throw, but Gady gets the rebound, and McKenzie Stanford with the putback. Lady Eagles lead by five now, 17-12.
Well, and a hard-fought offensive rebound right there by Emma Gady, and that's what you like to see. You know, Arkansas Fort Smith is having a little bit of an advantage right now in rebounding, but you got to get in there, scrap for it, fight for it. And we've seen in two straight possessions McKenzie Stanford get fouled on a rebound, and then we've seen Emma Gady go up and fight for an offensive rebound and give him a second possession that, honestly, Arkansas Fort Smith has been getting the second possessions, not the Lady Eagles.
And the Lions throwing the ball in from the right baseline. Thrown into Franklin on the left corner. Now with Castillo on the left corner, she drives in, throws up a shot, hits the backboard, and Audrey Hayes gets the ball, passes to Clift. Clift, the three-pointer, no good, and it bounces off the top, bounces off the rim, and then the top of the backboard, and they will say that is out of bounds. Castillo taking the ball up the court for the Lions. And the whistle blown, looks like they're looking at the clock.
Yeah, something with the scoreboard. They're gonna have to adjust something right now. But Oklahoma Christian shooting very well. They haven't shot a whole lot of threes, so they've only shot three compared to Arkansas Fort Smith, who shot six. But both teams have only made 1 3-pointer. So right now, three-point shooting is not really a factor in the game. But with players like Addie Cliff, you expect that to change as the game goes on.
McKenzie Stanford gets the steal, and it looks like she was probably tripped. She just kind of fell down. Sarah Parker down to Stanford. Stanford was wide open, yelling for the ball, but she passes it out to Clift. Clift on the right wing in the corner to Hayes. And the ball's knocked out of bounds by goalie.
Well, and I don't know if shouting really gets the full essence of what McKenzie Stanford was doing. She looked like she was trying to bring in a plane on, you know, the runway as she was just waving like crazy because she was so wide open.
And Stanford with a block. Her shot is blocked. She gets the rebound and misses the putback. And she knocks the ball away. Audrey Hayes picks the ball up, goes all the way down. And the layup is good. Lady Eagles lead by seven now with a little over a minute left in the first. Haynes takes a three-pointer, and that is no good. Kylie Hicks and Hannah Holosek checking in for McKenzie Stanford and Emma Gady.
And that's the thing about this Oklahoma Christian senior group is, you know, we saw all five starters were seniors tonight. But then when they check out, that, you know, a lot of times you have seniors that don't play a whole lot, that don't get a whole lot of time. But everybody on the Oklahoma Christian, everybody on OC's team that's a senior has gotten good minutes throughout the season. I mean, Hannah Holosek has stepped into the starting lineup at times throughout the year. Kylie Hicks was the starter early in the season, kind of, you know, after her foot injury, she kind of, you know, was on the coming off the bench for a while, but getting back in that starting lineup. Emma Gady may be the only player that's not really started a whole lot this season, but Emma Gady picks up a lot of those sixth man minutes, a lot of that those big second unit minutes for Oklahoma Christian.
And 40 seconds remaining. Lady Eagles ahead by four now. And a charge is called against Sarah Parker. And Coach Finley taking a timeout, and she's walking over to the ref to talk to him.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a winning number, 337-859.
But Coach Finley going with the timeout, basically just to talk to the ref about that call.
Again, the winning number, 337-859.
as she's still over there talking to him.
Well, and Sarah Parker picking up her second foul. I mean, that's pretty, you know, like we talked about earlier with Arkansas Fort Smith and their players having some foul trouble. You don't want Parker to be in foul trouble either, because she is one of those big scorers for this team, one of these seniors that's produced a lot for Oklahoma Christian over the season. You don't want her missing a whole lot of time tonight, especially if it is as close as it was the last time they played against Arkansas Fort Smith.
And Sarah Parker will check out of the game. McKenzie Stanford checking back in. Castillo over to Franklin on the left wing. And passed inside to Dickerson. And she puts up a shot, misses, but she kind of looked like she pushed her shoulder into McKenzie Stanford. Either way, nothing was called, and a shot was not made. Ball pass down low to Stanford. She goes up a little too far under the basket there, and it will go out of bounds on the Lions. Kylie Higgs throwing the ball in from the right baseline. And 1 second on the clock, and Kylie Higgs can't really get a shot off, and that will end the first period of play. OC leads 19-15, and we'll be right back with the second quarter right after this.
Open up your books to page 360.
Did you just look at your phone while you was in class? You played yourself.
Talking about inspirational quotes.
You gotta believe in yourself. Don't ever play yourself. The key is to make it, so make it.
Louise, can you give me an example of an inspirational quote?
Don't play yourself. The key is to make it.
And who said that?
I did. Now that's a major key alert.
Learn the real major keys to getting to college at getschool.com.
And welcome back to Eagle Sports Network. We're just beginning the second period of play here in the Eagle's Nest. Lady Eagles hosting the University of Arkansas Fort Smith Lions. Lady Eagles lead by 4, 19-15. Audrey Hayes with the basketball passes down to Cliff. And up top to Higgs and to Stanford. McKenzie Stanford driving in the paint, and a foul is called. That foul is going to go against Dickerson. That is her first. And because of the rules in NCAA women's basketball, that is just the first team foul now. McKenzie Stanford takes the jumper, misses, and it's rebounded by Haynes. Haynes out to Franklin. Franklin back to Haynes. She puts up a three-pointer, and that one's good. So the Lions, that was just their second three-pointer, but they have taken quite a few. Audrey Hayes all the way in for the layup.
Well, in Arkansas, Fort Smith has shot 25% from behind the three-point line. Oklahoma Christian shooting only 20%. They've only made three. And these are two teams that like to shoot three-pointers. You know, they've attempted 13, only three of 13 made between the two teams. And it's kind of interesting to see that right now three-pointers aren't a big, you know, difference in this game, because neither team is really hitting them tonight.
And a foul called against Kylie Higgs, that is her second. So two players for OC with two fouls. And Michaela Haynes at the free throw line. First one is good. And misses the second one. Audrey Hayes gets the rebound. Hayes hands it off to Clift. Clift to Holosek, hands it off to Clift, and it's stolen away by Dickerson. She drives all the way down, throws up a shot, and it will go out of bounds. They will say it was out of bounds on the Lady Eagles. Coach Finley not really happy about that call. There honestly was not a ref down there. And a shot put up by Dickerson is blocked by the Lady Eagles. Audrey Hayes with the ball at the top of the key. And the ball stolen away by the Lions. Stolen back by the Lady Eagles. Audrey Hayes with the ball. And Haynes knocking the ball out of bounds. Number two, Shea Scheffler checking into the game for 34, Audrey Hayes. We've really seen the ball go back and forth quite a bit lately in this game.
Well, both teams are having a little bit of turnover trouble. I mean, Oklahoma Christian has 5. University of Arkansas Fort Smith has 7. So not exactly perfect games from both teams.
And a good backdoor cut play by Hannah Holosek. She gets the layup to go in. Lady Eagles lead 23-18. And it gets away from the Lions. Hannah Holosek fighting on the floor for the basketball. And it will go out of bounds on Holosek.
Well, a good job by the Lady Eagles with the team defense. You know, they've been swarming to the players inside the paint, and that's led to a couple of turnovers inside the paint for the Lions. But also, it's led to the Lady Lions throwing up some shots that honestly are not good shot attempts. And we've seen from their shooting percentage, you know, they're only hitting 32% of their shots. They've hit 7 of their 22 shots. Not exactly a great shooting game so far from the Lady Lions.
Kylie Hicks down to Stanford and is stolen away by Franklin. Franklin's double teamed and a foul is called. That foul going against number 31, Hannah Holosek. That is her first foul and OC's second. Sarah Parker checking back into the game for the Lady Eagles.
And interesting right now, Kylie Hicks and Sarah Parker both with 2 fouls. They're both out there on the floor. You know, Sarah Parker just checked in for McKenzie Sanford. You've also got 2 players for Arkansas Fort Smith with a little bit of foul trouble, as you've got number 40, Taylor, and then number 24, Maya Perry, who picked up 2 fouls early in the first quarter. Interesting to see all 4 of those players in the game so early.
And right after you say that, Dickerson gets her second foul. So the Lions with 3 players on the court with 2 fouls, and we're not even to halftime yet. Lady Eagles throwing the ball in from the right baseline. At the top of the key with Hicks to Sarah Parker now. Dumped down to Holosek, and it will go out of bounds on the Lions. Shea Scheffler throwing the ball in again from the right baseline. Into Clift on the right corner. She puts up a 3-pointer, no good, and it's rebounded by Haynes. Haynes out to Dickerson to Franklin on the left corner. And inside to Taylor. Taylor misses the block shot, and it's rebounded by Parker. Shea Scheffler with the ball. Pass over to Holosek. Holosek drives in. The ball stolen away by Haynes. Haynes drives down on the right side, throws up a shot, and she's fouled. That foul is called against number 2, Shea Scheffler. That's Scheffler's first and OC's third. And that will send Haynes to the free throw line.
And both teams have had quite a few fouls early in this game, as Oklahoma Christian with 8 fouls of their own. And then you've also got, Oklahoma Christian with actually 6 fouls of their own. Arkansas Fort Smith with 7. Both of these teams have had several fouls, and they're, you know, for the most part, they're not calling a ton of fouls. But the thing is a lot of the players that are getting calls against them are getting multiple. So you've got, you know, players like Kylie Hicks, and Sarah Parker for Oklahoma Christian. And you've got three players for Arkansas Fort Smith with two fouls early in this game. And that could come into play later in the third quarter and in the fourth as well.
Addie Cliff goes all the way in, misses the layup, and a layup made by Taylor on the Lions' end. And Lady Eagles losing their lead now. The Lions lead by one, 24-23, with 5 minutes, 48 seconds remaining in the second. Shea Scheffler gets the screen from Stanford, the pick and roll play, and Stanford is triple teamed. She can't get the shot up. Dickerson with the ball, drives in on the left side, spins, puts up a shot. The layup is good. The Lions lead by three. Shea Scheffler down to Clift, inside to Stanford. Stanford with the jumper, and Lady Eagles down by one now.
Well, they mentioned it just a few moments ago. McKenzie Stanford, in this game, with the points she has scored, has moved into second in the all-time scoring list for the Heartland Conference. So really, you know, not a great performance today, but just a great performance for her entire career for McKenzie Stanford. And she's still got a little ways to go before she can get to first all-time.
And Stanford has 11 points in this game, so you never know. Maybe we will see a great game by Stanford. A little too early to tell. Emma Gady takes a shot from the free throw line. No good, and it's rebounded by the Lions. Brown drives all the way down, puts up a bad layup, and it's picked up by Parker.
And a good job by Scheffler to kind of get in the way and not allow her to have an easy look inside the paint and kind of making her go around Scheffler.
And Addie Cliff steals the ball back. The jumper is good from the left side, and that's the type of thing you want to see, because Sarah Parker went down, missed a three-pointer. Looked like Coach Finley was kind of disappointed she didn't take some time to run a play, but Addie Cliff with a good steal and then making the shot. And Perry gets two chances to put a block shot in, misses, and Addie Clift on the other end makes the three-pointer. Addie Clift with 5 points in a row, and the Lady Eagles now lead by four, 30-26. And Taylor gets the block shot to go in.
And we've now seen out near half court, we've seen two Oklahoma Christian players get knocked to the floor. Didn't see exactly what happened before that to lead up to that, but definitely something to keep an eye on, a little bit of chippiness maybe by Fort Smith.
And Sarah Parker with a layup. Lady Eagles lead by four, 32-28, 3:25 remaining in the second. And Hansen makes a three-pointer from the right corner. Scheffler with the ball on the right wing. Inside to Stanford. Stanford dribbles, and the layup is good. And the Lions continue to double-team Stanford. Addie Clift with the steal. And Addie Clift being really smart, hanging out down by the basket after the made shots by OC. And we have a timeout called, so we'll take that with them. Be right back on Eagles Sports Network.
Hands can do incredible things. Now they can even help save a life with hands-only CPR. If you see an adult suddenly collapse, just call 911 Then push hard and fast in the center of the chest until help arrives. Learn more at handsonlycpr.org.
Welcome back to Eagle Sports Network. We have 3 minutes and 2 seconds remaining in the first half of play. OC leads by 34-31. And the Lady Lions with the basketball. Haynes down to Franklin on the right wing. Back up top to Haynes. And Perry on the left wing now. Franklin with the ball driving in, and a foul is called. That foul called against number 21, McKenzie Stanford. Kind of an interesting call because Shea Scheffler and Gady were the ones on the ball, so from this angle, kind of hard to tell what really happened there. And a foul called as Haynes drives in, and that is going to be a charge called against Haynes. That's Haynes's first foul.
That's a big call right there, because if it goes the other way and McKenzie Stanford picks up her second foul, then that would be a big deal for Oklahoma Christian, because then you'd have Hicks, Parker, and McKenzie Stanford all picking up two fouls. And for Stanford, it would have been her second foul in just a few minutes of play.
Addie Cliff takes a three-pointer, and it's no good. And that was actually Haynes's second foul, so she checks out of the game. Brown comes in for her, and the Lions with four players with two fouls. Franklin on the right baseline, passes inside to Hansen. Hansen double team, throws it out to Brown. Brown drives in on the left side, layup is good, and the Lady Eagles lead is cut to three now. Scheffler driving in, passes inside to Stanford. Stanford back to Scheffler, and Scheffler's shot is blocked, but that will stay with the Lady Eagles.
Number 32, Zanisha Dickerson checking in for UAFS.
Franklin checking out of the game. Coming in for her is number 32, Dickerson. Scheffler with the ball up top. Down to Cliff. Cliff takes a dribble, passes out to Stanford. Stanford on the right wing. And all the way over to Gady on the left baseline, and Gady drives all the way in, and the layup is good. Lady Eagles lead by three, 36-33. Just under a minute and a half remaining in the first half of play. And a foul called against number 21, McKenzie Stanford, and that is her second foul. And OC's fifth, so that's going to send the Lions to the free throw line. Brown shooting free throws, misses the first one.
And neither team doing a great job shooting free throws tonight. Arkansas Fort Smith has hit 4 of their 7 free throw attempts. Oklahoma Christian has only hit 2 of their 4 for 50%. So not great free throw shooting percentages.
And Franklin checks back in for Hansen. Hannah Holosek checking in for McKenzie Stanford. Shea Scheffler taking the ball up the court. She's being closely guarded by Perry all the way down across half court. Emma Gady on the right wing. Over to Scheffler on the left wing, and down to Hayes. Hayes out to Cliff. Cliff drives in on the baseline, puts up a shot, and the jumper is good by Addie Cliff, as we have just under a minute remaining in the first half. Lady Eagles lead by 4, 38-34.
And while today is senior day and it's a celebration of the seniors for the Oklahoma Christian team, looking forward with Addie Cliff as one of the leaders on this team this year, and she's only a sophomore, she's still got 2 more seasons to play. It's good to see someone in the wings waiting for once those seniors graduate, Cliff taking over for Oklahoma Christian going forward.
And Addie Cliff goes down, misses the layup. 20 seconds remaining in this half, and Brown goes all the way down. The ball goes off of her knee. Kind of an interesting call there, but from this angle, it looked like it did go off of Brown. 11 minutes remaining in the first half. Addie Clift with the ball at the top of the key. And she drives all the way in, goes up for a layup. Not really close on the shot, but she's fouled. That foul called against number one, Alexis Brown. That is her first foul. And that will send Addie Clift to the free throw line.
Well, and on the drive, you know, Addie Clift's left arm when she was going up for the layup was hit. And so that was what led to that foul call and what led to her not making a good free throw, or excuse me, a good layup.
And Addie Clift with both of her free throws. And she puts OC up by 6, 40-34. 22, Megan Shelton checking in, as well as 32, Kylie Hicks. And a foul called against number 34, Audrey Hayes. That is her second foul. And a lot of people not happy with that call. Coach Finley yelling at the ref about that one. So that will send Brown to the free throw line again, as she missed her free throws a few minutes ago. First one's no good. 2.6 seconds remaining. And with that short amount of time left on the clock, you really didn't want to see OC pick up a foul there. And Brown makes the second free throw. Ball thrown into Gady. Gady dribbles down, puts up a three, bounces off the rim. So pretty decent shot with 2 seconds left. But Lady Eagles will go into halftime leading by 5, 40-35. We'll step away, be right back with some halftime stats right after this on Eagle Sports Network. Welcome back to Eagle Sports Network. We're at halftime of the Lady Eagles hosting the University of Arkansas Fort Smith Lions. Lady Eagles leading right now 40-35. So, and the last time these two teams played was at Fort Smith. Lady Eagles lost by 5, and we kind of saw them struggling throughout that whole game. So it's good to see the Lady Eagles with this lead right now.
Well, and early in this season, Oklahoma Christian had a problem with being close in the first quarter, but then ending up blowing it in the second quarter and giving up those leads, and then having to make huge comebacks in the second half. Now tonight, Oklahoma Christian has stayed very close. They've got a 6-point lead right now, and you wouldn't honestly be able to tell from just looking at some of the stats right now. OC shooting better percentage, 47% from the floor. Arkansas Fort Smith shooting only 38%, but they're out-rebounding Oklahoma Christian by 6, 24-18. Now, the big difference right now is some of Addie Cliff's steals. She has 2 steals, but a couple of forced turnovers later in the second half, as Oklahoma Christian had more turnovers to start off with than Arkansas Fort Smith. But now, Arkansas Fort Smith with 13 turnovers, Oklahoma Christian with 7. And right now, when you're getting extra possessions, when you're forcing them into turnovers, it allows you more opportunities to go back up and score.
And you mentioned Addie Cliff. She has 12 points in this game. McKenzie Stanford has 13. But Addie Cliff, one of the key players in this game so far today, and with those 2 steals and going down, scored 3 times in a row for the Lady Eagles, and that's what got them the lead back. And today being senior day, you want to see all of your seniors do great, but it's also good to remember you have players like Audrey Hayes, you have players like Addie Clift who are able, you know that they're going to be here next year and they'll be able to help this Lady Eagles team out. But real quick, take a look at other players on the Lady Eagles team talking to their seniors, and then we'll be right back after that short video right after this. Defense! Defense!
Emma came to us from Oral Roberts. She's a transfer. I couldn't even tell you maybe exactly how many years we've had her, but we petitioned for an extra year for her because she was hurt there. She was also hurt here, so her college career has spanned 6 years, and she's working on a master's. But this year, her senior year, she's been fully healthy and has really come in and gotten stronger and stronger, applied some of the experience she had picked up through those other years and helped us out, whether it's mentoring the younger girls and helping them out on the court with situations with her knowledge from Division I and from here. And she's applying that now to her game as well. She's really starting to come on and hit shots and maybe isn't thinking so much about the injuries as she is about the game as a whole. We've really appreciated the leadership and the maturity that she has brought to the team. Kylie's our overall best athlete. She's very athletic and probably the most unselfish player I've had in a long, long time. She never wants to look for her own shot, but is always trying to create things for other people. And that's what really helps team chemistry get going. When somebody plays that way and other people can feed off of it, she's one of the best rebounders we've had. She's strong, she can jump well, and she aggressively goes after the rebounds. We had a big win this weekend against St. Mary's, and she was a big key in that as she started the game off with gathering in every rebound that she could get close to. And I think it just kind of set an aggressive tone for the rest of the team. When she was playing that way, we all started playing a little more aggressive on the defensive end and trying to get every ball that came our way. And that was a big key in winning that game. So Kylie can set the tone even if she's not gonna be a scorer for us. She sets a defensive tone and a hustle tone that everybody else can jump on the bandwagon and go with. And so I'm just real pleased that her senior year has turned out the way it has. We've needed her to play some point guard, which has allowed her to start more games than she used to. And I'm glad to see her get that reward in her senior year because she's put in a lot of hard work. Hannah has been a real blessing to the team in leadership, I think. She's a very unselfish player. She doesn't have to start to be happy with her game. She's okay with her role on the team coming off the bench and defend the other players' good post when she comes in the game. And she does a good job of stepping into that role and concentrating on shutting them down. She's not worried about how many points she scores, but she's worried about how many points she's given up to that offensive player. So she has set the tone in that regard for people to understand their roles and come off the bench and provide what's needed at that moment. I might also add that she is from my high school. She is from my hometown and is the only player I've had from my hometown. So that was kind of neat this year to get to experience a couple of years with her, and her being from my high school is kind of fun. Dantej has been a part of the program for the last several years. She was a manager for us and was very knowledgeable and could get out there and work scout team if we wanted her to in being a manager. But this year, when our numbers were down a little bit and allowed for it, I asked her, because I knew in the past that she had wanted to be on the team, and so I just asked her if she would like to do that. I would like for her to do that. I would like for her to get that experience as a player if she wanted it, because I was so appreciative of what she had done for us as a manager. I wanted her to have that opportunity, and so when I offered that opportunity, she took it, and we both knew she would be graduating in December, so it might just be a one semester thing. She did want to take the opportunity to be on the team for a semester, and I just appreciate her attitude of wanting to experience that, being able to play just that one semester. And I think it speaks to her passion for the game, that she wanted to have that experience to fall back on no matter what she goes on to do in the future. That is a part of her experience now. And I appreciate her willingness to, once again, as I've said about some of the others, to be a role player and give that example to people of what it's like to be a willing role player on a team to make the team work. And I just love Dantasia and am so excited that we got to experience that together. Sarah came to us out of Butler Community College, and Sarah's college career took a lot of turns. She committed to Northwestern early out of high school, and we had our eyes on her a little bit, but I'm old school, and I was having a hard time getting my mind around this NCAA Division II recruiting and trying to get kids to commit early. Well, Northwestern made her an offer, and she took it. And I was sitting there waiting to watch her play her senior year and then see if I wanted to offer her in the spring. So she ends up at Northwestern, but didn't like her experience there the first semester and decided to go to a junior college so that she could then transfer to a four-year school after that. So we recruited her out of Butler Community College, and we're lucky enough to get her. She's been great for us. She has balanced the floor for us. She can hit the three. She can post up tough and get fouled and go to the line. She's automatic at the free throw line. So it has just been awesome for us to have her here. It's just been incredibly involved in FCA and has carried that on to the team, which has been good for the spirituality of the team as well. I think she has become one of the spiritual leaders, and I give credit to all those seniors for playing that role as well, to the underclassmen. But Sarah's been a big part of that and getting us involved in FCA quite a bit. We got McKenzie. There's a little story behind that too. As we were recruiting one of her teammates, McKenzie didn't get to play her junior year, so she was flying under the radar a little bit. And so we went to check out their first game her senior year, and I was so impressed with how she played at the front of their press that I wanted to get her. So we recruited her hard all year, and we were able to land her. And she's become a two-sport athlete, basketball and track. She's gone out for the track team every year and has done a great job for them. I said Kylie was our best athlete, and she is our best raw athlete. McKenzie's right there behind her in athleticism. She can jump, she can run, she can play inside and out. And for 4 years, we've had that ability with her. She's so versatile. And she has set the tone with her work ethic. She never takes a day off, and she never has a bad day. She always has a smile on her face. And she's the kind of personality that can get along with everybody. And so that has been such an invaluable leadership piece of our team for the last 4 years, even as a freshman. She just gets in the gym and works hard and sets that example. She works on her own. She works hard in practice. She's one of the first to get there and one of the last to leave. And I just love that she leads in that way. She's also been a big part of FCA. She and Sarah have done that together. And I appreciate that effect that they've had on the team and that interest that they've had to get the girls interested in something outside of the sport that can be spiritual for them like FCA can, and teach them leadership qualities as well. So McKenzie's been a big part of that. And like I said, she and Kylie have been here the 4 years together. They're the part of that class that came in together. Emma was a transfer, and the other two girls were transfers. Dontasia came in as being our manager and then a player. So really, Kylie and McKenzie are the core of that group that came in as freshmen, and they're still here sticking it out, and I just hope we can really do something strong here at the end of the year for both of them as they finish up their careers.
And welcome back to OC Eagle Radio and Eagle Sports Network. We're just a few seconds from beginning the second half of play here in the Eagle's Nest, the final home game in the Eagle's Nest for the season. So Coach Finley playing her seniors quite a bit in this game. Lady Eagles lead right now 40-35.
When you've got all of your starters back out there, which, of course, like you mentioned before, all of the seniors getting the start tonight. Kylie Hicks, Sarah Parker, and McKenzie Sanford have been starters for most of the season. Hannah Holosek has played. She's jumped into the starting lineup here and there at times. And then Emma Gady, she's not played as much in the starting lineup, but she is one of the big players in the second unit to get a lot of playing time.
And the Lions with the basketball, with Hansen down in the left corner. And Franklin now at the top of the key. And a three-pointer put up by Haynes. She gets her own rebound. And the putback by Perry is no good, but she's fouled by 31, Holosek. And that is Holosek's second foul. So everyone on the court for OC, except for Emma Gady, has 2 points. Gady doesn't have any. And the first free throw, no good. Second free throw, good. Lady Eagles lead by four now. Kylie Hicks taking the ball up the court, hands it off to Holosek.
Well, neither team really shooting great from the free throw line tonight. Both teams shooting just around 60% from the free throw line. Arkansas Fort Smith hitting 60% of their free throws. Oklahoma Christian, 67%. Not great shooting percentages from the charity stripe.
And Haynes misses the jumper. Lady Eagles with the basketball. Sarah Parker on the left wing. She drives him, puts up a layup, and the layup's good. Lady Eagles lead by six now, 42-36. Franklin takes a three-pointer, no good, rebounded by Holosek. Holosek with the ball on the left wing, hands it off to Gady. Now with Kylie Hicks on the right wing. 8 minutes, 40 seconds remaining in the third. Inside to Stanford. Stanford misses the layup, and it's rebounded by Franklin. Franklin pulls up at the elbow, kicks it out to Hansen. Hansen with a three-pointer, no good, rebounded by Haynes. Haynes to Franklin, three-pointer put up and made by Franklin. She's taken a lot of three-pointers, and that was her first made one today. Sarah Parker takes a dribble right by the basket, ball stolen away, and a foul called. Looks like it's called against Kylie Hicks. That is her third foul. So she'll check out of the game, and it looks like she took a hit to the mouth. And Audrey Hayes checking into the game for her. Perry with the ball on the right wing. Franklin now up top. Johansson on the left side. Now with Brown on the left wing. She dribbles up. Passes inside. All the way inside to Taylor. Taylor misses the block shot. Gets a rebound. Puts it back in. And Lady Eagles lead is cut to one now. McKenzie Stanford takes a three-pointer from the corner. No good. And it's rebounded by Perry. Perry to Hansen on the left wing. And up top to Brown. Back to Perry on the right wing. And back to Brown. Now inside to Hansen. Hansen takes a dribble, drives in, and another foul called. That foul going against number 31, Hannah Holosek. That is her third foul. So Lady Eagles still in a bit of foul trouble.
Well, Oklahoma Christian called for three fouls in this third period of play, and Arkansas Fort Smith called for zero. That's a little bit different considering both teams have been pretty close to the same on personal fouls throughout the game. Oklahoma Christian with 12 fouls called against them compared to 10 for Arkansas Fort Smith. So not really a huge difference between the two.
And
looking back at the replay, it's kind of honestly a weak call. You know, it didn't look like Hannah had extended her arm or shoved her or anything like that. There wasn't really a whole lot of contact, but still the call made. And obviously the referee saw something we didn't.
And she did kind of look surprised at that call. Fort Smith leads by one, 43-42. And Addie Cliff checked into the game for Holosek earlier. Brown drives all the way down, misses a layup. Stanford with the ball, passes down to Clift. Clift on the right wing, inside to Parker. Parker, the jumper is good, and Lady Eagles take back the lead, 44-43. 6.5 minutes remaining in the third.
And the basket right there was important, but on the other side, it looked like number one, Alexis Brown was going to have a free lane into the paint to get a layup for Arkansas Fort Smith. But Emma Gady and McKenzie Stanford both giving enough contact and giving enough pressure to where Brown kind of had to go a little bit harder to try and get that and have a little bit more struggle to try and get the layup. and ending up missing the shot, and big for Oklahoma Christian to come back down and then score after that.
And the Lions with a layup, and they get the ball back and the lead back, 45-44. Three-pointer put up, no good by Perry. Audrey Hayes with the ball, driving all the way in. It's up a layup, and a charge is called against Audrey Hayes, and she'll pick up her third foul of the game. That's also the fourth foul for OC in the quarter, and University of Arkansas Fort Smith are yet to have a foul called on them. Hanson with the ball up top for the Lions. And over on the left wing, down to the corner, and to Dickerson. She misses the block shot, and the putback is blocked by Emma Gady. That will go out of bounds on Gady and stay with the Lions. And the Lions throwing the ball in from the left baseline. Throws it in to Hanson. Perry at the top of the key. Hanson on the right wing now inside to Dickerson, and Gady knocks the ball out of bounds again. So the Lions throwing the ball in from the right baseline this time.
And Gady doing a good job of protecting the paint.
And an easy layup by goalie. And the Lions lead by three now, 47-44. Addie Cliff with the ball to Parker. Parker puts up a three-pointer. No good. Rebounded by Perry. Perry driving down on the right side all the way in for a layup. And the Lions lead by five now, 49-44.
And Oklahoma Christian shooting 15% from behind the three-point arc. 2 of 13 compared to 4 of 16 for Arkansas Fort Smith. They're only shooting 25%, so neither team's shooting well from behind the three-point line.
But that is something you usually see Oklahoma Christian doing a lot better in that area. But we have a timeout called, so we'll take that media timeout with them. Be right back after this. Welcome back to OC Eagle Sports Network and OC Eagle Radio. Lady Eagles are down by 5, 49-44, with 4 minutes, 33 seconds remaining in the third. Michaela Haynes with the ball up top for the Lions. Inside to Hanson, and Hanson called for traveling. So Lady Eagles basketball now. Audrey Hayes taking the ball quickly up the court, drives all the way in on the right side. Layup is made, and she's fouled. So great job by Audrey Hayes seeing open court, being able to drive all the way in, and that is something we tend to see from her. And now the chance for a three-point play. Audrey Hayes at the line for one. And the free throw's good. Lady Eagles down by two now, 49-47, 4:15 remaining in the third. Franklin on the left wing, up top to Perry, and inside to Goalie. And Goalie is called for traveling. Two refs called that travel, so that's the right call. Very obvious one. Audrey Hayes with the ball up top, and it's knocked away by Haynes. Hayes throwing the ball in from right by the Lady Eagles bench. And she throws it in to the right corner with Clift. Clift drives in a little bit, puts up the jumper, and it's good. Lady Eagles tie the game up at 49 now. 3:40 remaining in the third. Haynes with the ball up top to Perry. Back to Haynes. And Franklin on the right wing. Inside to Taylor. Taylor makes the layup and she's fouled. That foul called against number 10, Emma Gady. She picks up her first foul, but that is OC's fifth.
And that's going to put Arkansas Fort Smith in the bonus for the remaining 3 minutes and 24 seconds of the third. Now, OC only has one foul called against Arkansas Fort Smith in this third period. Now, you obviously don't want to say, oh, well, the refs are helping them out or anything like that, but sometimes there is. Hey, we're not getting any calls going our way this period. We're going to have to play and play through the whistle and just hope, you know, we may not get the calls go our way.
Stanford misses the jumper, and it's rebounded by the Lions. Perry quickly up the right side, open. Dickerson wide open on the left side. She gets the block shot to go in. Audrey Hayes drives all the way in, tries to put up a shot, and it's blocked. He'll go out of bounds on Taylor. Lady Eagles down by 4, 53-49. Sarah Parker misses the three-pointer, and it's rebounded by Taylor. Haynes with the ball on the right wing. Inside to Dickerson. Block shot, no good. Rebounded by Dickerson. The putback is no good. And McKenzie Stanford gets the rebound.
Well, we've seen Oklahoma Christian, a good rebounding team, but tonight, or excuse me, today, Arkansas Fort Smith really out-rebounding the Lady Eagles. They've got 38 rebounds compared to 24 for Oklahoma Christian. They have 16 offensive rebounds, only 6 for OC, so they lead in the offensive rebound area alone by 10 rebounds. And that's why Arkansas Fort Smith has this 4-point lead and why it's been, you know, Oklahoma Christian has been fighting, even though they're shooting better, they're having a better shooting percentage tonight and having some other things go their way. The rebounding is a big difference.
And we saw just now McKenzie Stanford airballing a 3 from the top of the key. And down on the other end, number 24, Maya Perry called for a foul. That is her 4th foul, so she'll check out of the game. Alexis Brown coming in for her. And that was the 2nd foul called against Fort Smith in this period. Hicks taking the ball up the court. And the pick and roll by Addie Cliff. Addie Cliff all the way in for the layup. And a travel called against Alexis Brown. Addie Cliff thought the ref blew the whistle for a foul. So she turned around looking really surprised there. And ball stolen away by the Lions. Franklin goes all the way down. Layup is good, and the Lions lead by 4 now, 55-51. Addie Clift at the top of the key. Over on the left side, takes a long three-pointer, misses, and it's rebounded by Gady. Hicks with the ball now, over to Holosek, back to Gady. Gady sinks the three-pointer from the left side, and the Lady Eagles cut their deficit to 1, 55-54, just over a minute remaining in the third. Addie Clift almost with the steal there, being careful to not foul. Haynes with the ball on the right corner. She drives in, puts up a jumper, no good. Rebounded by Brown. Brown misses the putback, and it's rebounded by Dawkins.
And a good defensive effort there by Gady to defend the shot.
And the ball goes all the way down out of bounds. The foul called on number 22, Tamara Goley. And 40 seconds remaining in the third. Ball thrown in from the left baseline for the Lady Eagles. And the refs taking a minute to separate the players from each other because he saw a little too much contact between the teams. Ball thrown into Dawkins. Loses it, but gets it back. And passes out to Hicks. Hicks at the top of the key to Clift, and a foul called. And that foul called against number 3, Michaela Haynes. That is her third foul and the team's fourth. So we're seeing the fouls be called more often lately against the Lions. Addie Clift on the left base, on the left corner. Back up top to Gady, inside to Dawkins, and they lose the ball, but it gets loose from Taylor. Addie Clift gets it back. She drives in on the left side. A foul is called. So that foul called against Haynes. So that's her second foul within just a minute. 13 seconds remaining of the third. Addie Clift at the line for two, sinks the first one. Audrey Hayes, along with McKenzie Stanford, checking into the game, coming in for Hannah Holosek and Kylie Hicks. Addie Clift at the line for her second free throw. And the second one's good. Lady Eagles take back the lead, 56-55, 10 seconds remaining in the third. Castillo with the ball up top. Dickerson takes the three-pointer, makes it, and the clock will run out to end the third period of play. So we'll take a quick break. Lady Eagles down by 2, 58-56, going into the fourth. We'll be right back after this.
Your books to page 360.
Did you just look at your phone while you was in class? You played yourself.
Talking about inspirational quotes.
You gotta believe in yourself. Don't ever play yourself. The key is to make it, so make it.
Louise, can you give me an example of an inspirational quote?
Don't play yourself. The key is to make it.
And who said that?
I did. Now that's a major key alert.
Learn the real major keys to getting to college at GetSchool.com.
Welcome back to OC Eagle Sports Network and OC Eagle Radio. We have 10 minutes remaining in this ball game. Lady Eagles hosting University of Arkansas Fort Smith Lions. And with just 7 seconds going off the clock, a foul already called. That foul against number 32, Zanisha Dickerson. That is her third foul and the first of this quarter.
Well, we've seen things get a little bit heated, a little bit tense here at the Eagles' Nest. There have been a couple of times where the refs have had to stop play and kind of say, you know, hey, you know, let's settle this down. Now, obviously nothing, you know, awful, but definitely a little bit of something to watch, especially if this game gets out of hand on either side going down the stretch.
And you have the two teams fighting for third place in the conference, so you know there's a little bit more tension than normally, probably. McKenzie Stanford trying to get the block shot to go in, misses, but she's fouled. Second foul called against the Lions. That foul called against number 32, Dickerson. And the first free throw by Stanford is good. And second free throw is good as well. Lady Eagles tie the game back up at 58. Number 2, Shea Scheffler checking into the game for 34, Audrey Hayes.
And foul trouble really coming into play for the Lady Lions down the stretch here in the fourth quarter, as Taylor Taylor has three fouls along with Dickerson. Then you've got Perry and Haynes, both with four fouls. They're not on the court currently. And you definitely could see that having an impact going down the stretch if they're not able to play quite as much as they have earlier in this game.
Shea Scheffler taking the ball up the court as the Lions just got a jumper to go in. So they lead by two now. McKenzie Stanford on the right corner drives in on the baseline, kicks it out to Gady and to Clift. Clift drives in, puts up a jumper. No good, but she's able to get her own rebound as Hope Dawkins knocked the ball back to her. She takes a dribble and misses the layup, or her shot was blocked. Franklin with the ball on the left wing into Dickerson. She drives in, and a foul called against the Lady Eagles. That foul is called against number 21, McKenzie Stanford, her third foul. And that will send Dickerson to the free throw line.
Arkansas Fort Smith shooting 60% from the free throw line. Now 10 of their 16, so a little bit more than 60%. Oklahoma Christian shooting 82%, 9 of their 11 free throws. And we talked about just a moment ago, though, Arkansas Fort Smith with a little bit of foul trouble. You've also got foul trouble for the Lady Eagles, as McKenzie Stanford with three fouls, along with Hannah Holosek, Kylie Hicks, and Audrey Hayes, all with three fouls. So several big-time players for this team with several fouls, and then Sarah Parker with two fouls as well.
And ball passed down to Parker. Parker with the layup, and Lady Eagles down by two now, 62-60. 8 minutes remaining in the fourth. Hansen with the ball on the left wing into Dickerson on the free throw line. She takes a dribble and a jump ball called. And Sarah Parker right there by Dickerson, and Dickerson just kind of shoved Parker in the face. And the ref's going to discuss what they're going to call here.
Well, she didn't quite shove her in the face. She did shove her in the chest, looking back at that replay. And Dickerson's been a little bit heated at times tonight. You see right there, she throws a shove on Parker, and just totally unnecessary, uncalled for. And it's going to cost Arkansas Fort Smith, and it's going to cost Dickerson as well.
And, you know, we've seen in other games with the men's team as well, when two players kind of talking and they end up calling something going both ways. In this case, it really didn't look like Sarah Parker said anything. But the refs going over to talk to Coach Finley about what they're going to call. And Sarah Parker will be the one to go to the free throw line for the intentional foul called.
Technical foul. And a good job by Parker and Shea Scheffler as well. You know, a lot of times when stuff like that happens, there's always a second, you know, something, some sort of retaliation, some second action that leads to both teams getting called for technical fouls. But Sarah Parker stepped back. Shay Scheffler comes in and grabs Parker to hold her back as well, just to make sure they know, hey, something just happened right here, and we are not going to get a technical foul called on ourselves. We're going to make a smart move right there.
And Sarah Parker makes both of the free throws. And OC ties the game up at 62. Ball thrown down to Parker, and a shot is blocked by Taylor. And the Lady Eagles will throw the ball in from the right baseline. And Shay Scheffler having to quickly decide where to throw it into, taking a little time there. But she gets it into Parker. Ball thrown into Holosek. She goes in for the layup. And that ball goes out of bounds on Taylor. So the Lady Eagles will get the basketball on the left baseline. Thrown into Parker. Parker takes the jumper from the left elbow, makes the shot, and the Lady Eagles lead by two, 64 to 62. Perry on the left corner, she's fouled. That foul called against number two, Shay Scheffler. That is her second foul, and OC's second as well.
And right now, it's kind of impressive that Oklahoma Christian has been able to stay in this game. They're getting definitively out-rebounded by Arkansas Fort Smith, 43-31. Arkansas Fort Smith has as many free throws as Oklahoma Christian's made, even though they've had a couple more attempts. They've made two more three-pointers. Oklahoma Christian only made two more shots from the floor in general. And Oklahoma Christian's been holding in strong, though, being smart with the ball. That, you know, they're not getting the rebounds they want, but they forced Arkansas Fort Smith into 18 turnovers compared to only 10 for themselves. And also just the fouls have been pretty even, so it's a pretty evenly matched game. Oklahoma Christian's going to have to try and find something to be the difference in the game. And right now it's points off turnovers, 23 points off turnovers compared to 10 for Arkansas Fort Smith. That is the difference for Oklahoma Christian. But they're going to have to keep playing like that for the remainder of this game.
McKenzie Stanford and Addie Cliff checking into the game for Hannah Holosek and Shay Scheffler. The Lions with the basketball now. Franklin on the left wing. Pass down to goalie in the left corner. Back up top to Perry. And over to Haynes. Haynes takes a dribble. Passes inside to Taylor. And Taylor is fouled. That foul called against number 33, Sarah Parker. So now everyone on the court for OC with three fouls. Everyone except for Addie Clift. And the first free throw by Taylor is good. And the second free throw good as well. The Lions lead by two, 66 to 64.
Well, if you look back at that replay, it looked like Sarah Parker got all ball when she hit the ball, but there was definitely some body contact, and that was kind of what they saw and what they ended up calling for the foul. But right now on the floor, these are the five players that have started the most as a group, as a collective group. Audrey Hayes getting 23 starts this season. McKenzie Stanford, Sarah Parker have started every game this year. And then Addie Cliff getting 18 starts. Kylie Hicks getting 22 starts. These are the players that have played the most as starters together.
And McKenzie Stanford misses the shot, gets the rebound, and the putback is good. Great play by McKenzie Stanford to stay in there, even though she was double-teamed most of the time. But Stanford ties the game back up at 66 apiece. And we'll take a quick timeout and be right back on OC Eagle Sports Network.
We cannot be bystanders.
We can stop to make sure someone is okay.
We can warn someone when their drink isn't safe.
And disrupt the situation.
We can
get someone the cab.
Or walk them home safely.
We can make campuses safer for our friends.
Our roommates,
our classmates,
our fellow human beings.
We cannot be bystanders.
We can
intervene.
It's on us.
All of us.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Welcome back to Eagle Sports Network. We have 5 minutes 59 seconds remaining in the ball game here in the Eagle's Nest, the final home game of the season for Oklahoma Christian. And right now, OC and University of Arkansas Fort Smith tied up at 66. And when OC played at their place, they lost by 5. And this has honestly been kind of similar to that game, as OC stayed in the game the whole time. But these two teams fighting for third place in the Heartland Conference today. The Lions with the ball, Franklin on the left wing. And a stolen away by Hayes. Hayes goes down on the right side, all the way down to the right corner, throws the ball away, and it's picked up by Perry. Perry driving down on the right side, puts up a shot, and she's fouled. That foul going against number 32, Kylie Hicks. That is her fourth foul.
Maya Perry.
So she's the first OC player to pick up her fourth foul. But multiple players with 3 fouls. And Perry makes her first free throw.
And Kylie Hicks with a little bit of too much arm contact that led to the foul being called.
Eagle basketball.
Second free throw good as well. Fort Smith leads 68-66. Kylie Hicks with the ball at the top of the key. Over to Hayes on the left wing, inside to Stanford. Stanford takes a dribble, puts the jumper up, and it's good. Lady Eagles tie the game back up at 68. Franklin on the right wing, up top to Haynes. And Haynes out to Perry. And she misses the jumper, and it's rebounded by Hicks. Hicks hands off to Clift. Clift puts up the 3-pointer, no good. And it's rebounded by Perry, but it will go out of bounds. And they say it's out of bounds on McKenzie Stanford. She didn't look like she was anywhere close to the ball. But either way, we'll take a quick media timeout. So we'll take that with them and be right back after this commercial break.
Hospital of St. Anthony's, Excellence in Orthopedics, the orthopedics of choice for Oklahoma Christian Eagle Athletics. And as always, Compadres Coffee Roasters. Check them out at CompadresCoffeeRoasters.com.
Listen, I realize that I'm not perfect, but it all really started to change because you judge me for having a problem. No one is going to know that I need help. I need help. I know that no one is going to judge me for having a problem. I realize that I'm not perfect, but it all really started to change because you listen.
Welcome back to Eagle Sports Network. Lady Eagles and the University of Arkansas Fort Smith Lions tied up at 68 apiece.
Well, looking at that last replay right before commercials, it looked like Arkansas Fort Smith was the last one to touch the ball. It looked like they knocked the ball out of bounds. Unfortunately, you know, the referee's not coming over to try and check the replay. They're going to say it's still with Arkansas Fort Smith, but it definitely looked like the Lady Lions threw it out of bounds.
4:41 left in the Eagles' nest to make some noise.
4 minutes, 40 seconds remaining in the ball game. Haynes is double teamed. She passes down to Taylor and Kylie Hicks and Audrey Hayes with some good defense there to not allow Taylor to score. Addie Cliff with the ball on the right side, up top to Hicks. Kylie Hicks dribbles to the right wing, passes inside to Stanford, and back out to Parker. And Clift on the left wing, she drives all the way in, puts up the jumper from the block, and Lady Eagles take the lead 70-68.
Well, we're seeing some big scoring games from several of the Lady Eagles, as McKenzie Sanford with 19 points, Addie Clift with 20 points, and Sarah Parker with 15 points. So all three of those Lady Eagles with a lot of points, and they're a big reason why OC is in this game and has been so close against Arkansas Fort Smith.
And OC forces the turnover on the other end, gets the ball back, and a foul called against number four, Sydney Franklin. That is her first foul. And the team's fourth. Both teams with four fouls in this quarter.
Olivia Hansen checking in for UAFS.
Hansen checking in for goalie. Addie Clift with the ball at the elbow. Misses the shot, but Stanford gets the rebound. And she puts up the short corner shot, and it's good. Lady Eagles lead by four now, 72-68.
And OC has been out-rebounded a lot tonight. Arkansas Fort Smith with a 10-rebound difference. They've also got five more offensive rebounds. But McKenzie Sanford's offensive rebound right there was very important and is, you know, they've got a four-point lead, but that one was a very key rebound right there.
Audrey Hayes taking the ball up the court for the Lady Eagles. Passes over to Hicks on the left wing, back to Hayes in the corner. And at the top of the key with Hicks now. 3 minutes remaining in the game. Addie Clift on the left side drives into the corner, passes out to Hicks and to Parker. Parker puts up a shot. And it's no good, and the shot clock will run out.
UAFS basketball.
And with 2 minutes and 45 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter of play, those type of offensive possessions could come back to bite you. Now, obviously, OC has a four-point lead, so it's not like they're trying to make a comeback. But that offensive possession could be a difference in the game.
And Haynes with the ball on the corner, back up top to Franklin. She puts up a three, no good. Rebounded by Hicks. Hicks down to Hayes. Hayes wide open. Tries to go up for the layup, not close, but she's fouled. That foul called against number 40, Taylor Taylor. That is her fourth foul. And good job by Audrey Hayes, and that's something we've seen all season by her driving in and drawing the fouls. And the first free throw is good by Hayes. That also puts OC in the bonus for the rest of the game.
And Audrey Hayes, 8 points tonight. Misses the second free throw, but Hayes has been a big player as the next offensive scorer after Stanford, after Parker, after Addie Clift. Then you've got Audrey Hayes and Emma Gady, and this is a really good team all around. It's going to be very dangerous when they go into the Heartland Conference Tournament.
Addie Clift with the ball now on the left side, and back over to Hicks on the right wing. Passes in to going to Parker, and a foul called. That foul called against number 33, Sarah Parker. That is her fourth foul, so Hicks and Hayes, Hicks and Parker with the foul, with four fouls.
Her fourth foul.
And a little bit of confusion right now. The referees looks like they're debating because that puts Arkansas Fort Smith in the bonus. Should they go to the free throw line, or was that a foul where it's just Arkansas Fort Smith gets the possession, and obviously Arkansas Fort Smith just getting the possession, not the foul shots.
And the Lions all the way in with the layup. OC leads by three, 73-70. Hayes trying to throw into Stanford, and it goes out of bounds on Franklin. Hayes throwing the ball in from right in front of the Lady Eagles bench. thrown into Hicks. A minute and 30 remaining in the game. McKenzie Stanford on the right wing, driving in, and a foul called. So that will send Stanford to the free throw line, and that will be the fifth foul for Taylor. So she will check out of the game. Number 22, Bully, checking in for her. Hannah Holosek also checking into the game, coming in for Sarah Parker.
Lady Eagles, number 31, Hannah Holosek.
McKenzie Stanford at the line for two now.
McKenzie Stanford at the line.
She has 21 points in the game today. Make that 22 with the first free throw. OC leads by four. And second free throw good by Stanford as well. That was one of those times you really needed to make those free throws, and Stanford came through for the Lady Eagles, extends their lead to five, a minute 15 remaining. And Franklin throwing the ball into Perry, but it's kicked by Addie Clift. So the Lions throwing the ball in from the right baseline. A minute 12 remaining in the ball game. Thrown into Franklin. And back up top to Haynes. Haynes driving in. Kicks it out to Hansen. Hansen to Goalie. Goalie puts up the three. No good. Rebounded by Clift. Under a minute remaining now. Addie Clift, long throw down to Stanford. The layup is good. Great throw by Addie Clift to get it all the way down. As Addie was not even across half court yet, she throws it all the way down to McKenzie Stanford.
Game clock being adjusted by 1 second.
And the ref's going to take some time, put some time back on the clock. Looked like they added a little over a second to the clock there. OC leads by seven, 77 to 70.
And a great job by McKenzie Stanford, getting down the court, being open down on the other end, because right after, you know, Arkansas Fort Smith missed that shot, you know, they're focused about not letting him get across half court. But then Stanford's all the way down there and gets a nice shot to go in.
And Kylie Hicks gets the rebound off the missed Lions jumper. Addie Clift on the right side, 30 seconds remaining in the game. Clift pulls the ball out. They're going to try to run some time off the clock. Driving in on the left side. And Addie is finally fouled. So she'll go to the line for two. 19.3 seconds remaining in the game.
And that's foul number five for Michaela Haynes, so that'll end her day as well.
And Castillo going to check in for Haynes.
And checking in for your Lady Eagles.
Sarah Parker also checking into the game, coming in for Audrey Hayes. Emma Gady about to check in for Addie Clift after the free throws. And the first free throw is good. And second free throw by Addie Clift, good as well. And Addie Clift will end her day with 22 points. 19.3 seconds remaining. And Coach Finley choosing to put all of her seniors back on the court for the remainder of this game. The three-pointer missed by Hansen. The putback no good by Goalie, and Kylie Hicks gets the rebound, and Emma Gady will try to dribble the ball out until the clock runs out. And Lady Eagles with a great win today, 79-70, and they will take the third place in, or be the leader of fourth place, have sole possession of fourth place in the Heartland Conference. So Lady Eagles getting a good win here today. Coach Finley getting her 601st win of this season. We'll be right back with some interviews and stats right after this.
Guess what? I have some news for you. There's free food right there, junk food. You see that truck?
Oh, jeez.
It's a 2-Michelin-star chef, all for free, ladies and gentlemen, all for free.
Here we have a panzanella with summer vegetables and pesto. Enjoy. Okay. How we doing? Fantastic.
So what do you got going on underneath that plate there?
This food is really about to be thrown away.
Yeah.
Is there something wrong with this food?
Where did you get it from?
From farmers markets. They put aside the ugly vegetables and the ugly fruits.
Carrot top, soft avocados. It was all food that was going to be discarded.
Even the drink you had is made from like a little bruised peach. Did it taste a little bruised?
It was good.
The average person throws away 24 pounds of food a month.
That's a lot.
Isn't that a lot? Go visit SaveTheFood.com for more information. Thank you. Junk food time!
I'm not gonna lie, definitely not easy.
Hey, whoa, 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 whoa.
Just gotta get through today.
How do you stop it?
Being used to doing something with a cigarette makes it hard doing it without one. If I can relearn to get through my workday without cigarettes, I can relearn anything without cigarettes.
Relearn life without cigarettes, free at becomeannex.org. A new way to think about quitting.
Questions?
What kind of service plan does this come with?
Unlimited.
Can I keep my same phone number?
Absolutely.
How do I change the ringtone?
Just hook it up to your computer.
Does it have a camera? What's the warranty? Does it come in silver? Can I put my party shuffle on this? Does it have a 3.5 millimeter headset jack? You sell a lot of these?
It's the one I carry.
You ever get those phantom vibrations in your pocket?
Any questions?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Ask questions. For the 10 questions everyone should know, go to ahrq.gov.
This can't be happening.
This can't be happening.
Of course it's not happening. Armored car. Listen, having money isn't about luck. Make your own coffee, save $1,000 a year. Feed me.
Feed the pig.
Welcome back to Eagles Sports Network. Lady Eagles getting a good win here today in the Eagles Nest. And won the game by 9 points, 79-70. And just a great game overall by the Lady Eagles to stay in there, stay fighting throughout this whole game, and end up with the win today.
Well, and throughout the game, it was pretty evenly matched. Oklahoma Christian ends up shooting about 6% better from the floor, hitting 41% of their shots. They shot 3 of 21 from behind the three-point line for only 14%. Not a great three-point shooting game. And this is a good three-point shooting team. But here were the things that made the difference in the game. They forced 20 turnovers for Arkansas Fort Smith, only 12. They finally won a turnover battle in a positive way this season. They had 25 points off turnovers, only 12 for Arkansas Fort Smith. But down the stretch, it came down to their leadership. Who was going to take the shots? Who was going to make the difference in those final moments of the game? McKenzie Stanford with 25 points and 12 rebounds, a double-double on senior day in her final night in the Eagles Nest. He also had Addie Cliff with 22 points and 4 rebounds, Sarah Parker with 15 points and 7 rebounds, Audrey Hayes with 8 points, Emma Gady with 7 points. You had an all-around game from a lot of different players, but a lot from those leaders and especially from those seniors tonight.
Well, like you said, we're saying Lady Eagles just all-around good basketball. You had your five seniors on the court for majority of the game. They started the game, played a lot of the second half as well, and ended on the court as the time ran out today. So we'll step aside and be right back with some interviews as well as the guys' game coming up right after this.